Hey, yay! Hey, everybody, how are you?
I'm John Richardson.
It is Representative
Jack Patrick Lewis's birthday. It's a little concert that we're doing, and you're all here too. I'm so happy that you're here. Ronald says happy birthday, Jack. He says a very happy birthday. Hey, Edward, how are you? I'm so glad y'all are here. I'm John Richardson. They just brought me so that I would play you all some songs. And if you have any requests during Jack's birthday celebration, you let me know. It's a pleasure to have you all here. I'm going to sing a quick song or two, and then you'll get to see the birthday boy. It goes like this. It goes, blue jean baby, L.A. lady, seems she's for the bay. Sing along at home, it goes like this, ballerina. Ballerina, you must have seen her dancing insane. Welcome everybody. Now she's in. It's Jack Patrick Lewis's birthday party. Time to dance in my hand. Jeremy, hey there. Hope I now. Hope he loves a tiny dancer. Count the headlights on the highway. Lay me down. Hey, Matthew. Sheets of linen, yeah. Hey, everybody. Had a busy day today. Sing it with me now. Here we go. Hope he loves a tiny dancer. Yes, yes, that's all true. Listen, I'm so happy that you're here. Thrilled. It's Representative Jack Patrick Lewis's birthday. He informed me that I'm supposed to call him Jack. But he's an elected official, and I respect him very much. So I'm not going to officially call him Jack until he comes into the room after this next song. I want to thank you all for being here. We're here to celebrate Jack. If you're here to celebrate Jack, please give a wave or say hi or happy birthday or something like that, because we need to do that. That's good. Jack wants to know that his party has a million virtual people at it. That makes a person feel good. And you let us know where you're watching from. I bet a lot of people are watching from Massachusetts. Behind me is a rainy Boston. Yes, it's true. Cheers, everybody. Okay, so this next song, this next song is a very good song if the representative that you're doing a birthday party for is gay. It's Lady Gaga. That's right. I can say that because so am I. Whoa, whoa. I want you grim and rolling along as it's free. I want your love. I love this song. love, 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 I want your love.
Birthday party. My name is John Richardson. I'm so thrilled that you're all here. We're here to celebrate Jack and also support him. So I don't want to waste any more time. I'm wondering, can we please bring in Representative Jack Lewis?
Hey!
Hey there. Let me just fix one thing. There. Can you hear me?
I can
hear you. Hey, Representative Jack Patrick Lewis, hello.
Excellent. Well, please, the only people who call me Representative Jack Patrick Lewis are lobbyists who don't know me very well or like me. Jack.
I'm not a lobbyist.
And thank you for bringing the quality music. I've still never been to P-Town, but I feel like you're bringing a little flavor of P-Town to Framingham this evening. And
it's
maybe I'll make the pilgrimage.
Yay.
Oh, well, I am just so grateful that you're here. And to everyone watching, thank you, thank you, thank you. I love serving as your state representative. And I know in reality for many of you, I'm your state rep adjacent or maybe one of your honorary state representatives. But in all seriousness, serving your families, our communities, and our Commonwealth is nothing short than the dream come true. And I just hope you all know how much you truly mean to me. I wish we were all huddled together at a local brewery, but our world reality makes that impossible this year. So I just want to thank you for your flexibility. I hope you'll keep engaging with our live musicians and one another through the chat function on Facebook and YouTube. We're all figuring out this new technology and this new way of being. And I'm just so happy that so many of you are able to celebrate my birthday with me this year. I love doing this event each year with you. Last year, if you remember, this event was snowed out, and then we had three other events that I had planned that all had to be canceled due to COVID. So I am definitely missing seeing you all in person, and definitely look forward to the day where we'll all be together again, hopefully at a local brewery, sampling some delicious refreshments from a locally owned business. In all seriousness, though, for a second, these last 10 months have been nothing short of catastrophic for so many. We have been tested in ways that none of us ever imagined. Each of us has been called to live our lives differently in order to protect one another. And I want you to hear me today say thank you, thank you, thank you. This pandemic has greatly harmed those who already live at the margins of our society, those who have long been forgotten, saddled with great housing and food insecurity. But this pandemic has also harmed those who have never felt that they needed to turn to neighbors or to their communities for the sort of support that is now required. Thank you to all of you for showing up for one another. Our collective efforts through our cities and towns, along with our Commonwealth, have served as an essential partner through this pandemic, and none of what we've done would have been possible without all of you. This new reality has caused us to completely shift the role of our office as your state representative. For the first 16 months, not 16, shoot, it's almost over. For the first 6 months, it seems like 16 months, but for the first 6 months of this pandemic, I had the great honor of co-chairing daily meetings with the 61 member of the House Progressive Caucus to exchange emerging best practices and to coordinate our efforts, urging local and statewide leaders to respond more aggressively. As this pandemic struck Asia and Europe hard, I maintained regular communication with colleagues abroad, working to bring a comprehensive and global approach to our pandemic response. Our office has also helped to rectify hundreds of constituent unemployment issues. And because of your ongoing financial support, we advertised information on state services and COVID-19 safety in more media platforms and in more languages than ever before. This has been a crazy year. We have so much to mourn, but we also have so much to celebrate. And I'm happy that you're with us this evening to celebrate together. We're gonna have a new occupant in the White House in just under 2 months. The Massachusetts legislature has passed comprehensive environmental legislation, police reform, and most recently the Roe Act. And we all know that successful COVID-19 vaccine trials are giving us all a glimmer of hope. I know that this would not be possible though without your support and all of your steadfast efforts. Together, we're gonna make sure that 2021 is not only a better year than 2020, but that we as a society rebuild together in a stronger, more equitable way to ensure that those who have been failed by our current system are failed no longer. We're here to celebrate, so I'm gonna stop before I forget that this is not a sermon and go into another 20 minutes or so of unprepared remarks. So I'm gonna turn things back to John because I'm sure you'd rather hear him sing something other than me.
No, I was loving that. I thought it was great. So, Jack, as we were getting ready for this, I found something out about the next song that we're going to do, because the next song goes a little bit like this, right? Now, I want to hear the story about why I'm doing this song here right now.
Well, first of all, I love the song. It's a great song.
Yeah.
Dolly Parton is one of my favorite people on the planet. Ooh. She has a unique ability to unite progressives and folks who live in the middle of the country and an eclectic group of folks. Love her and worship her, and I'm finding her among them. But early on when I was running for office, and we were here in this home with my campaign team, often really early in the morning and really late at night, I would play the song. And when I was elected and my great staffer, Sarah and I would go into Boston, way earlier in the day than we needed, way earlier than I'm sure she wanted. We sometimes go into Boston at 7 a.m., sometimes a little earlier, when virtually no one was there. We'd have to turn on lights. And as we sat down on our computers to plan the workday ahead, I put on 9 to 5 by Dolly Parton, just to make us laugh, but also so hopefully she knows how important she is to me and the great work all of our staff do, working so much more than just 9 to 5, but often the early hours in the morning and wee hours of morning on the other end. So
absolutely. And by the way, I need to tell you, Jack, Kim says that she's loving your COVID hair.
I'd like to say it's all.
Well, don't mess it up. She likes it.
Oh, thank you. I'll stop touching it.
Well, fabulous. All right. Well, I'm going to play 9 to 5, and then I have a very special person to introduce. And so I'm going to make sure that this is all set up here. I want to just say hello to everyone who's joining us for the first time. This is an event for our friend, my friend, and your friend, Jack Patrick Lewis, Representative Jack Patrick Lewis. It's his birthday. So as I play this next song, I'm going to play this Dolly Parton song. And I hope that you'll sing along and at home, wherever you are. Tumble out of bed, stumble to the kitchen, pour myself a cup of ambition, and yawn and stretch and try to come to life. Out of the shower, the blood starts pumping, out on the street, the traffic starts jumping with folks like me. I'm down 9 to 5. Sing it with me, working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taking and no giving. They just use your mind and they never give you credit. It's enough to drive you up crazy if you let it, yeah. Well, they take your dreams just to watch them shatter, just to step on the boss man's ladder. You got dreams that they'll never take away. In the same boat, a lot of your
your friends, waiting for the day your ship will come in, when the tide's gonna turn and it's all gonna roll your way. Sing with me, working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living, barely getting by. That's right, it's no taking and no giving. They just use your mind and they never give you credit. It's enough to drive you up crazy if you let it. 9 to 5, yeah, for service and devotion. You would think that I would deserve that promotion. I want to, you have, but the box won't seem to let me. I swear sometimes that man is out to get me.
Now our friend Jossie down there, Jossie, that was 9 to 5 by Dolly Parton, and obviously it's a very special song to Jack and his team, but it's also a very important song to one of my favorite Democrats of all time. This was Elizabeth Warren's song all throughout the campaign, 9 to 5, and she's a hero of mine, and I'm sure to many of you as well. She's my senator, and so I have one of the great pleasures of my life. I'm about to say these words. It's an honor to welcome to this broadcast Senator Elizabeth Warren.
Hello, everybody. I am so delighted to be here with all of you tonight to wish our good friend, Representative Jack Patrick Lewis, a very happy birthday. Now, I wish we could all be together in person to do this. We would share hugs and pinky promises and selfies, but we know that's just not possible right now. Even so, I wanted a chance to be with you this evening because this is a time of tremendous crisis for our nation. People are dying from COVID-19, hundreds every day. Our economy is being squeezed to its breaking point, and people can no longer deny the evidence of profound racial injustice in our nation. This is tough. But leaders like Representative Lewis and strong Democrats like all of you, we don't give up. You know what this fight is about, and you stay in this fight. Because of bold progressives like Jack, Massachusetts has been a beacon of light, shining hope all across this country. We need Jack's leadership in the fight for our families and communities across the Commonwealth, and to continue the fight for the kind of change that touches people's lives. These fights are hard, but you don't get what you don't fight for. So I'm honored to be with you today, and I am honored to wish my friend Jack a very, very happy birthday. Jack, we're in this fight together.
Elizabeth Warren. Hello, Elizabeth Warren. Hello. You didn't hear her say it, but she, in that video, she also said, "Hey, John Richardson, thank you for all your support." She did. Some people must have missed it. Yes. I love Elizabeth Warren. She just wished Jack a happy birthday, so he's a happy birthday boy right now. There was a request that came in for some Ricky Martin. And after Elizabeth Warren, I think it's only appropriate to play this song. Talk to me, tell me your name. You blow me all like it's all the same. Ricky Martin. Woman in history, yes, that's right. Ooh. Yes. I want to sing a little song before I introduce our next guest. Oh, Elizabeth Warren was here. I'm still getting over that. But I want to do one song before we introduce our other fair senator, our wonderful senator, Senator Ed Markey. We're going to ask him to come in just after this, but I thought I'd play a quick verse of a little song before we do that. And maybe you know this song. It's a fun one to sing along. Carrie went to 2 Ricky Martin concerts back in the day. Carrie, I'm very jealous. That's great. Hey, cheers, everybody. Let's have a cheers to Jack. Everybody, happy birthday to Jack. This cheers is just for him. Happy birthday. Cheers, everybody. Thanks for being here. Now, when I play this next song, there's going to be a scroll. It's going to go across the bottom. It's going to start here, and then it's going to go over there. And it's going to give you a URL website that you can donate to Jack, obviously to all the campaigns that he has forthcoming. But it's a wonderful opportunity. This is a fundraiser for Jack. And so we'll put up the little URL that will allow you to find out where you can donate directly to him to have him continue all the great work that he does for folks in Framingham and Ashton. Yes, it's good. You see right there? Oh, there it is. It's cute. It's not scrolling. Scrolling is distracting. Now, I know that some of you love this song as much as I do. Please come to Boston for the springtime. I'm staying here with some friends and they've got lots of room. You can tell Darlene, it's bourbon. By a cafe where I hope to be working soon. Darlene, are you drinking? Please come to Boston, she said no. Boy, won't you come home to me? You sing with me now. She said, hey, rambling boy, why don't you settle down? Boston ain't your kind of town. There ain't no gold and there ain't nobody like me. I'm the number one fan of the man from Tennessee. Now we'll skip a little part, a little bit, because it goes on. He like asks her to move to basically every city ever, and that's true. So we'll just pretend that we're going to L.A. Please come to L.A. and live forever. That's awesome. Staying home alone is just too hard to get. I live in a house that looks out over the ocean. And there's some stars that fell from the sky living upon a hill. Please come to L.A. Please come to L.A. She said no. Boy, won't you come home to me? She said, hey, rambling boy, why don't you settle down? L.A. ain't your kind of town. There ain't no gold and there ain't nobody like me. I'm the number one fan of a man from Tennessee. And now with that, I want to welcome our senator. This is an amazing man, fresh off of a re-election victory, and the co-author of the Green New Deal with AOC. I want everyone to please welcome Senator Ed Markey.
Thank you so much for having me this evening. Tonight I have the great honor of wishing my great friend and partner in service, Representative Jack Lewis, a very happy birthday. When you Google effective legislator and progressive champion, my friend Jack Lewis's photograph pops up. As the chair of the Progressive Caucus, he is somebody who understands the issues affecting the lives of his constituents, and he works tirelessly every day to ensure that every person's voice is heard. He knows that we have to create inclusive government policies so that our system works for every single person in Massachusetts. And as a fierce advocate for climate change solutions, healthcare for all, LGBTQ rights, I am proud to have such a strong and effective voice and partner in the Massachusetts State House. Our fight for justice and equity in Massachusetts and across the country is far from over, and that's why we need Jack to be up there and hear his voice. So Jack, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jack. Happy birthday to you. Thank you all for being here to celebrate such an incredible leader. Happy birthday, Jack.
He has a really good voice. He's got a good voice. He's going to put me out of a job. Jonathan, you should not have played the end of that video. Jonathan Hawkins is my producer here tonight. And he is making all of this run so smoothly. He's amazing. We've been doing a lot of these for political campaigns over the last couple of months. And Jonathan, I'm very angry that you let Ed Markey sing because he has a really good voice and he kind of upstaged me. Now I have to sing after a senator. It's not good. I want to sing a little protest song that's one of my favorites. He has a great voice, Blaine, I agree. Gather around people wherever you roam and admit that the waters around you have grown. Accept it that soon you'll be drenched to the bone. If your time to you is worth saving, then you better start swimming or you'll sink like a stone. For the times, they are a-changing. Woo! Hey, Betsy, how are you? Hey, Tara. Kara, how are you? Jane, what's up? Now, next we have, after a verse more of this, or two, we have Senate President Karen Spilka, and I'm so excited to welcome her. She is singing along. She likes this song. Come, senators and congressmen, please heed the call. Don't stand in the doorway and don't block the hall. For he that gets hurt will be he who has stalled. There's a battle outside and it's raging. It'll soon shake your windows and it'll rattle your bones. For the times, they are a changing. Come mothers and fathers throughout all the land, and don't criticize what you can't understand. See your sons and your daughters, they're beyond your command. Your own road is rapidly aging. Please get out of a new one if you can, and then for the times, they are a-changing. Now without further ado, I want to welcome an amazing person, Senate President Karen Spilka. Yes. Hi.
Hello?
Yes.
Hi, I'm not certain if you can hear me.
I can hear you.
Okay, I wanted to wish Jack a very happy and special birthday. I will not sing to you. That is my birthday gift, to not sing. But I do want to just be a part of this celebration and to just say what a pleasure it's been to get to know you so much better, get to know your family, to work with you in partnership and friendship in the legislature. You know, you're a very, very hard worker. You bring a wealth of information and knowledge and compassion and empathy. Somebody that I really appreciate turning to get advice and to just brainstorm with, not only for Ashland and Framingham, but for the whole Metro West region and for the state. I really, really so appreciate you including me to wish you a wonderful, warm, happy, and healthy special birthday and year ahead. Let it bring only good things. And basically, I wish that all your birthday wishes come true. Take care and celebrate, Jack. Congratulations.
That is so sweet. Karen Spilka.
She is awesome. One time she came to Provincetown and she saw, and Julian Sear was there too, and she saw a concert of Donnelly and Richardson, and she was the nicest person. She was. I met her. It's true. Well, listen, I'm honored to have gotten to see her even virtually. Hi, thank you all for all that you do for the Commonwealth. And I'm thrilled to be here. My producer, Jonathan, we're thrilled to be doing this with all of you, celebrating Jack Patrick Lewis. So I want to next introduce an amazing person. I want to introduce someone who knows Jack better than anybody else, more than his husband knows him, more than his children know him. It is his colleague from Framingham. This is Representative Maria Robinson. Hey, Maria.
Hi. Thanks so much. I'm not Joe Biden. I'm sorry.
You seem great, though.
I'm pretty okay. I'm not as cool as Jack, and I don't sing as well as Ed Markey does. But, you know, we do all right. This is such a Jack event, and I love it so much because it's both whimsical, full of spirit and love and joy, and also scheduled down to the minute, which is just Jack in an absolute nutshell here. We've talked a lot about all the amazing ways in which Jack leads and what a wonderful soul and empathetic person he is. I think it's often overlooked. You know, we'll hear later from Senator Julian Sear, who is the only out gay man in the Senate. But Jack is the only out gay man in the House out of all 160 of us. So he does a lot of heavy lifting in terms of representation. And I know how hard that is. There's like six of us women of color as well in the House. So it's not always easy when you don't have, you know, folks who look like you or have the same gender identity as you surrounding you. And I think that's so important that he's bringing that representation every single day, and he's bringing his most authentic self to the House every single day, which is probably at least 25% my fault that he's becoming more authentic over the past couple of years since we started to serve. He would kill me if I didn't say he was also one of the youngest people to serve in the House as well, which I think is another form of representation. And of course, a wonderful adoptive parent, and his love for his kids comes through in every single conversation that he has, in every single speech that he gives on the House floor. And we are so gosh darn lucky to have Jack. I don't think people understand how lucky we are to have someone with such a big heart and such a big soul representing and bringing people together, working through really difficult issues, working with a lot of different personalities, and he is phenomenal, and we need to keep him here, and so I'm grateful. I don't know if we're celebrating birthdays. Are we technically celebrating birthdays? I thought it was COVID year. Birthdays were off. I don't know. You'll be 29 forever in my heart anyway, Jack. So happy birthday, my friend, and it is an honor to serve with you every single day.
Oh, what a wonderful tribute. Well, yes, we are. Maria says, are we doing birthdays during COVID? And we're doing this kind of birthday. So it's kind of weird, but also kind of fun. Thank you so much, Representative Robinson. It was wonderful to meet you. And I expected a few more embarrassing stories about Jack during that speech, but it's okay. It's all right. I'm not mad. Now, I am so happy to be here. I'm going to sing a little song. We all want you to show your love for Jack tonight by commenting and saying hi to him. But also, there's a very easy way to donate. And you can see the scroll at the bottom. This is going to go across. I'm going to sing a song up from Golden Girls about being a friend. And so if you're a friend of Jack's, please check out the scroll at the bottom and consider making a donation. Times are very difficult, and we know that. So any contribution is very much appreciated. So thank you very much for watching and for donating. Thank you for being a friend. Travel down the road and back again. Your heart is true, you're a pal and a confidant. Yeah. And if you threw a party, yeah, invited everyone. This gift would be for me, and the card attached would say, thank you for being a friend. introduce a very, very dear friend of mine. This is the person that I do these shows with, who is the mastermind behind all these very complicated events, and that is my dear friend, Mr. Jonathan Hawkins, who's going to make a very special introduction.
Wow, how embarrassing. I'm running this entire thing and my microphone was muted. It has been such a pleasure getting to know Jack over the last few months. I first met him when I did the first virtual Boston's Earth Day back in April. And since then, I think he has been a part of four or five different events that I've had the honor of producing, from Boston's Earth Day, the Boston Vegetarian Society, to the Victory Fund fundraiser, and the Stonewall Democrats. It has been such a joy to get to work and get to know Jack. Framingham and Ashland are so lucky to have him as a representative. And I'm just honored to be able to be a part of this evening. I had intended to sing a song for you. However, the internet and the weather in Provincetown are not cooperating. And instead, it is my great honor to introduce my state senator and my dear friend, Mr. Julian Sear. Hi, Julian.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm good. We're not very far from one another, but
I know this weather's insane.
It's cooperating. I'm gonna fix this. No, it's wild. But I'm so thrilled that you boys are doing this for Jack. So John and Jonathan are, I have a lot of constituents, but are two of my favorite constituents, and a real part of this younger new generation of young queer folks, right? Who are relatively young. making things happen on the outer Cape, right? And creating a life here. And that work is sort of so important. And I love that y'all connected with and found Jack Patrick Lewis, who is another kindred, young queer millennial who is just making change happen in Ashland and in Framingham. So Jack, this is so cool. And who knew Ed Markey could sing? I literally was like texting all my political friends being like, Ed Markey sings, this is amazing. And to be joined by Senate President Karen Spilka, who I have the honor of getting to work with every day, Maria Robinson, who's just a fierce force in the House, and all celebrating you, Jack, for your birthday, which I don't exactly know how old you are. I think you're 1 year, 2 years older than me, but anyway, this is such a great little gathering, particularly because, you know, although the world seemingly has stopped, the work of the legislature hasn't stopped, and certainly our political work hasn't ended. So, you know, the real unfortunate part of the job that we have to go do, and one of the harder things that we have to do, right, is the political work, and particularly the fundraising work. And so, you know, Jack kind of having this creativity of saying, all right, you know, look, we've still got to raise money. We still got to build and support one another. But let's do it in an innovative, fun, socially distant way. And so I think doing that is just fantastic. Having Jack in the House is really something special. There are only a handful of us. There's only 7 out elected officials in the Massachusetts House and the Massachusetts Senate. And Jack and I are the only 2 male identified folks right now. And I can tell you that having queer voices in the legislature really matters, right? When we're going to bat on reproductive justice issues, having someone who can speak for the needs of LGBTQ youth, someone who's not only not that far from youth, but is also a parent, being in that room and having representation matters. And this is a community that really has understood that representation really has mattered. And we've figured that out, yes, through political organizing, and yes, through our ability to support candidates who win. And so getting to have Jack as a partner, as a sibling in crime, if you will, is just so essential. And we've worked on legislation. I'm still hoping we can get done by the end of this legislative session around support for HIV prevention, all of his leadership on LGBTQ youth issues. Excuse me, Jack. I probably should have had your birthday drink before I got on the call. And then on really, you know, core progressive matters, right? Where You know, COVID-19 has only just revealed how the inequities in our society really are gaping fissures and need to be rectified. And Jack's leadership as the co-chair of the Progressive Caucus in only his second term in the House is no small achievement. So I could go on and on and on, but you've got some phenomenal, talented musicians who you want to hear from. But before I go, I do want to ask folks, this is a fundraiser. And running for office, it takes a village, especially when you've got re-election every 2 years. So I know times are tough. You know, a lot of us are in a much more precarious financial situation. There's a number of us too who actually, because of COVID-19, I know you're saving money because you aren't going out as much. So whatever you can do, please make a contribution to Jack Patrick Lewis and his campaign committee. The maximum donation you can give in a calendar year, which is coming up to the end of the year, it's $1,000 per person per year. I want to ask you to give your maximum contribution. So whether that's $20 or the full $1,000, having Jack in the legislature is so, so, so essential. We need to make sure that he continues to be on a strong financial footing so that he can continue to represent not only Ashland and Framingham in the House, but represent all of us on Beacon Hill. So again, happy, happy birthday, Jack. Lots of love, wishing folks a lot of health and safety in this most difficult time. And yeah, on a nice day, come on, drive on down to P-Town and we can do a socially distant walk with me and John and Jonathan and we'll have a good time. So lots of love, honey, happy birthday. You know, I can sing too.
Oh, well, that's coming up a little bit later.
I don't know
if you
it's coming a little bit later. All right. Happy birthday to you, Jack. Lots of love.
Thank you, Julian.
Jonathan, I'll see my two of my favorite constituents very soon, I'm sure.
I'll see you later. Thank you, Julian. And on that, there are several of colleagues and friends of Jack's from across the Commonwealth, the country, and the world who also wanted to wish Jack a very happy birthday. So let's say hello to them now.
Hi, this is Representative David Linsky from Natick, and I'd like to welcome all of you to Jack Lewis's Bar Mitzvah reception. Yes, I'm thrilled to be here to help celebrate this important day in 13-year-old Jack Lewis's life. Yeah, I guess he is older than that, but not much. He will always be young Jack Lewis to me, and more than that, he'll always be my friend and my excellent colleague. From my neighboring city of Framingham. Even though I'm from Natick, I still love him. So I wanna wish Jack Lewis a very happy birthday and to say thank you to Jack for being such a great colleague and a great friend and a wonderful state representative for Framingham and for Ashland. He is looking forward to a much better 2021 than 2020. Jack, thank you for all you do and have a happy birthday.
Hey, happy birthday, Representative. I'm sorry we can't be together to celebrate in person, but I just want to thank you for being such a great partner on everything from tackling healthcare disparities to public education. You're out there every day working hard for families across the state. So be well, my friend. Happy birthday.
Hi, I'm State Senator Jamie Eldridge, representing the Middlesex and Worcester District, and want to wish a happy birthday to my friend, Representative Jack Lewis. I really enjoyed serving with you, Jack. We work on a number of progressive issues, from solar issues to protecting immigrants to investing more in education. And I want to thank you for your patriotism. I want to thank you for your work to move the Metro West region forward and our fight for a brighter and bolder Commonwealth. Happy birthday, Jack, and sorry we can't be together this year.
Happy birthday, Jack. I cannot wait until we actually can celebrate in person and we're not checking in with each other through these Zoom chats. But I just want to thank you so much for all of the work that you're doing for Framingham and Ashland. I am so, so proud to get to work with you every day and looking forward to another session with you leading the Progressive Caucus and being a great, great partner for legislators all across the state.
Hello, I'm State Representative Tammy Govea, and I'm here to wish a very happy virtual birthday to my dear friend, State Representative Jack Lewis. It is an honor and a privilege to serve in the Massachusetts House of Representatives with you. I am so grateful for your commitment to leading and legislating on behalf of the residents in your district and also all across our state. From advocating for access to critical needs such as food, housing, and healthcare, to fighting for civil rights and social justice causes, you are always on the right side of every single fight that the people in Massachusetts care most about. I am deeply grateful to you. I'm also impressed by your leadership of the Progressive Caucus and your commitment to progressive democratic values. Jack, thank you for all that you do. Thank you for bringing your full self every single day in service to others. Happy birthday, my friend. I look forward to celebrating with you in person next year.
Happy birthday, Jack. I wish I could be with you in person to celebrate, but I am so grateful for your friendship, your leadership, getting to work with you in your role as co-chair of the Progressive Caucus, and all the amazing work you do for our shared communities of Ashland and Framingham. Happy, happy birthday, many happy returns, and all the best in 2021.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jack. Happy birthday to you.
Pikachu!
Hey, Jack, all the way from the land of Oz, wishing you a very happy birthday. Keep up the great work. Keep being the strong advocate that you are. And I hope that we can see each other soon. Happy birthday.
Birthday, Jack. Jack Lewis is a rising star in the progressive firmament and a great colleague and partner. You're having a great year, and we're all having a great year with the election of Joe Biden and Kamala Harris. And it's such a pleasure to work with you and looking for great times ahead. Have a wonderful birthday and a wonderful year.
Happy birthday, Jack. Greetings from the Berkshires. I'm so thrilled to be part of your birthday celebration. Our time together leading the Progressive Caucus has been one of the greatest joys of my legislative session. I really wish you the best this coming year.
Hi, Jack. Happy birthday. Greetings from across the pond. We may be divided by the Atlantic Ocean, but we're united in our work as LGBT politicians. The state of Massachusetts is very lucky to have you as a proud advocate of our LGBTQ friends and brothers and sisters, but also as an advocate for people, a champion of human rights. I look forward to working with you on many issues in the coming years. Enjoy your birthday celebrations. Happy Thanksgiving and stay safe.
Happy birthday, Jack. My name's Kevin Morrison. I'm a commissioner in Cook County. I've gotten to know Jack through his involvement and his work with the Victory Fund and the Victory Institute. I'm so proud to support a leader like Jack Lewis, and thank you all for joining me in supporting and celebrating him today. Thank you.
Oh my gosh, that was so touching. As those videos came in, I refused to watch them. They just blew me away. So thank you to all of my colleagues locally and across the state and across the country who were able to send in those videos. It means so much to me to have colleagues and have friends like all of you to do this important work with. And I'm just so, so grateful that you all tuned in tonight. I'll admit, I was a little nervous when it started raining that this would be my fifth event in a row that had to be canceled. But the power is still on, and the internet's still going, and the kids are quiet and doing something somewhere in the house, and the dog's only starting to bark. But really, thank you, thank you, thank you. For those of you who haven't stopped by Dulce de Leche yet, in Ashland or Framingham, we're doing something special with them. If you donated or are on any of my email lists, you should have got a coupon for a free celebratory cupcake available today through, I think, Sunday. If you didn't get a coupon, just shoot me an email or a text and I'll make sure you get it. But definitely stop by, support them, pick up your free cupcake. But again, thank you, thank you, thank you. And really a special thank you to Julian and John. And John, I feel like I don't need to go to P-Town now. You've brought P-Town to me, so I can check that off my bucket list and stay here and play.
No way. Well, listen. Everybody that's here watching this stream, we want to sing our friend Jack a happy birthday and finish off this wonderful little live stream right. And so I think that if you would please join me, and you can even write the words to happy birthday down in the comments, that would be very fun. It's like we're all singing together. So Jack, can I sing you happy birthday? Should I start singing you some happy birthday? We like that.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jack. Happy birthday to
you. Oh, yay! Are they helping us sing?
To
got some friends helping you out, some cool candle blowers outers. We love that. Yes. Happy birthday, Jack.
Oh, thank you. We forgot to pick up our cupcake, so the kids took a homemade protein bar that I made yesterday and made a fake cupcake for all of
That's
us.
That's great.
This I'm sure will be delicious and healthy.
I bet it'll be great and healthy, and it'll make you become very strong.
Yeah,
you'll become the Hulk just from that. Well, everyone, please send a final birthday thank you. I'm going to wrap up here and finish up with one last little song or two. I want to thank Jack and wish him a very happy birthday from me. It's so clear from everyone on this thread how important you are and how important your work is. And I'm so grateful that there are progressive folks like you fighting for LGBT rights and for the environment and for everything that we value here. So thank you very much, Jack, and happy birthday to you. Yes. So I figure we should finish off with a few of the fun ones. Hey, Kathy. Hey, Andre. How are you? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hey, Elizabeth. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Last dance, last chance for love. Yes, it's my last chance for romance tonight. I need you by me, beside me, to guide me, to hold me, scold me, 'cause when I'm bad, I'm so, so bad. So let's dance, last dance.
Let's dance, the last dance. Let's dance, the last dance tonight. Oh, it's my last chance, last chance for love. Yes, it's my last chance for romance tonight. I need you by me, beside me, to guide me, to scold me and hold me, cause when I'm bad, I'm so, so bad. So let's dance, the last air, let's dance, the last air, let's dance, the last dance tonight. Oh, yeah.
All right, listen. It's Massachusetts, so we gotta do. Yes.
Is that right? Okay, yes. Good. Good. We love it. Yes, it's good. All right. I want to thank all of you so much for being here with our friend Jack Lewis. You can see the way to donate is down there. Look at that. It's going right there. Yes. So grateful that you're all here. I want to finish up with a very Massachusetts song. Very Massachusetts. Hey, Cesar, how are you? Good to see you. Yes. We can't do an event for a Massachusetts politician without this song. La da da, ya ba 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 ba, la da da, la da da, ya ba da. I want y'all to sing Sweet Caroline with me. Da da, where it began, the ba 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 ba. I can't begin to know where, but I believe that it's going strong. 5, 6, 7, 8 was in the spring, ba 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 ba. This spring became the sun. Hey, Paula, who'd have believed that you'd come along? Now I want to see your hands. You sing this part with me. It goes like this. Hey. Touching hands, hey Spencer, reaching out, yeah, touching me, touching you, a 5, 6, 7, 8, sweet Caroline, ba, 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 good times never seem so good, so good. Thank you, Chris. John Richardson, I do a thing called Virtual Piano Bar, and I'm so thrilled to be here with all of you celebrating Mr. Jack Lewis. He's amazing. You can still donate. Yes, look at that. Hey, Parwez. Hey, thank you all very much for watching. I'm going to sign off now, but thank you so much for being here, and happy birthday to Jack Lewis. See y'all later.